Say, Selenium class 20, web elements and actions on web elements. See, in this chapter we are going to discuss two topics. One is web elements, another is actions on those web elements. See, in web testing, not only web testing, if it is desktop application or web application, we conduct most of the testing using front end objects or elements. Some type of testing, example database testing. For database testing, no front end object reference is required, but for most of the test operations, front end objects of front-end object or element reference is required. Our tool, test tool, Selenium supports web application testing. So we need to familiar with web elements and the actions on web elements. This is theory chapter. Tomorrow I will show practical. See, first topic, web elements. Browser. See, our Selenium point of view, browser is not an object. If it is UFT, in UFT, browser is object, page is object, link is object, all are objects. But here, using driver object, Selenium web driver browser object, we can handle browsers. Next, page also high level. Next, come to web elements. Edit box. Next, text box. Next, link. Powerful object in the web, link. Next, button. Push button. Next, image. Image object having three flavors, three types of image. Image. Hello, Baba Wale.
How are you doing?
Okay. Image, general image. Next, image button. As like push button. See, user friendliness point of view, web developers use image buttons for some operations or some elements. Next, image link, as like text link. Next, text area present in the application. Text area, this is static. Text area is static. Observe Shivangi. Suppose Yahoo Mail. Oh. Observe Shivangi. Enter your email. This is edit box, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
This is next blue color element. This is
button.
Okay. Next, what is this one? Yahoo makes it is easy to enjoy what matters most your world.
Text area.
Yes, it is text area. Okay. Text area. This is static. Next. Error message. See, in testing, we need to handle this text area. No need to handle text area, only verifying the text. Next, we have to handle error messages. Okay, text area. Next, just a minute. Read if mail. See, username 8 box, password 8 box, go button. See, without entering username and password, try to click this button. It is showing error pop-up. What is this one? It is error message. See, error message. Actually, it is pop-up. It is not web element. We can't inspect this element. It is Windows element. For example, just a minute. Gmail. Just a minute. Remove. Observe Shivangi. Email or phone. It is 8 box. Forgot email. Link. Not your computer. This is text area. Create an account. Link. Next. Next is button. See, without entering email, without entering email, try to click this next button. Error message. This is web element only. See that error message displayed in the same page. You can inspect that error message. You can inspect that error message. See, inspect element. You can inspect. See, this is error message. Earlier, we saw that rediff mail, that is pop-up window. Pop-up window also static, but it is not web element. Next, checkbox. Checkbox. Next, radio. Radio button. Next, drop down. Drop down box. Next, combo box. Combo box. Before this, list box. What is the difference? We will discuss. List box. Next, combo box. Next, web table. Web table or HTML table. It is also static. Web table or HTML table. HTML table. Next, frame. Section of a web page. Frame. Any other, Baba Wale, any other list out?
I think you covered pretty much everything.
We covered maximum. Next, some arrangements are there. Observe Shivangi. Suppose Facebook. Just a minute. It is taking. Observe Shivangi. First name 8 box, surname 8 box, mobile number or email address 8 box, new password 8 box. Next here, birthday is there na? Birthday. What is this element?
The drop down.
Drop down. Drop down. Okay. All these are drop downs. This is special arrangement. Special arrangement. It's not separate element. Arrangement. Date picker. Date picker na? This is date picker. Okay. Next, Go to Google home page, Google home. Observe Sri Lalita, Google home. Say Gmail link, right side top, images link. Next, here one icon is there, Google apps. Click this one. Here some links are there. What is this object or element? Sri Lalita, what is this one?
Those are partial links or links, sir?
Links only, image links. If you click this one, it will redirect to YouTube. Redirect to YouTube. See, observe. Google Apps icon is there. Suppose if you click to search maps, it will redirect to Google Maps. See, Google Maps. All are image links. Inside this arrangement, all are image links. What is this element? What is this arrangement? Do you hear this term? Inline elements. Elements in a document. Inline elements. Observe Baba Wale. Inline elements. Next. Suppose Amazon.com. Observe Sivangi. This is menu. Menu, okay. Why it's not? Just a minute. Link only. Tomorrow I will show that one. One more arrangement. Mouse hover. Do you hear this term, mouse hover, Sivangi?
Yes, sir.
If you place mouse on an element, then it will display options.
Yes, sir.
See, these are the maximum web elements and arrangements. Next, come to one by one. First, we will discuss manual operations, manual actions. Tomorrow.
Sir, tab controller, is there any content like this in one frame? We display multiple tabs.
Where? Can you show me?
No, sir. Tomorrow I'll show you.
Okay, tomorrow you show me. See, most of the time, these are the standard elements. These are the standard elements. Remaining arrangements. Date picker is arrangement, inline elements arrangement, mouse over arrangement. Okay, tomorrow you show me, I will explain.
Yes, sir.
Observe. Actions on web elements. We will discuss manual actions on web elements. If it is manual testing or automated testing, you need to familiar with web elements and actions on web elements. If it is manual testing, you can conduct actions manually. Suppose Gmail link in Google home page. Click is action. If it is manual testing, testers clicks that element. If it is automated testing, Selenium clicks that one. We guide Selenium. Okay. First one, browser. It is not web element. Using driver object, we handle browsers in Selenium testing. Browsers. What are the important actions on browsers? Observe Sri Lalita. Important actions on browsers. Launch browser. Launch browser. Isn't it? If it is manual testing, we launch browser manually. We launch browser manually. If it is automated test, if it is automated testing using Selenium, Selenium will launch the browser based on our test design, isn't it? Launch browser. Next, navigate to a URL or gets a URL. Next, primary operations, close browser window. Next, close all browsers that opened by Selenium during execution. Sometimes we may open multiple browsers, closing all browsers. In manual testing also we conduct that one. See, these are primary operations. Next, other operations also there. Navigate from one URL to another. Regularly we conduct this operation in real life also while browsing internet. Observe Anuradha. Next, navigate back to previous URL. Next, navigate forward to. Next, minimize the browser window. Next, maximize any other. Tell me Anuradha, actions on browser.
Sir, refresh, sir.
Yes, before refresh, one more also there. Browser full screen is there now?
Yes, sir.
In our testing, full screen not required, but option is there. Our Selenium WebDriver command also there. Browser full screen. Full screen. Next, as you told, that refresh. Browser refresh. If you refresh the browser window, what will happen, Shivangi? If you refresh the browser window, what will happen?
So the window will be refreshed and the contents will be reloaded.
Yes, page will be reloaded. It reloads the page.
Yes.
Suppose sometimes if you conduct specific operation, you want to update that one. That time refresh not required. You can get update buttons in your application. Sometimes application hangs. Suppose our application, our web page is not responding. After some time it is not responding. That time if you refresh the browser, it will reload the page.
Yes.
Next. These are regular operations. Next, testing point of view, sometimes you need to capture browser URL and compare with your expected. See, in real life, we don't capture. Sometimes we copy that URL and paste in another browser, that is different. Here, verification point of view, we capture URLs. See, capture current URL. In yesterday's test case also, we captured URL after login. Captured current URL. Next, capture window title, window handle, window handle, browser window handle. Anuradha, suppose if you want to work with multiple browsers, then you need for identifying the browser, Selenium uses this window handle. Window handle, etc. See, these are the maximum operations on browser. If it is manual testing or automated testing. Before moving to next element, tell me, Anuradha, what are the important actions on browser?
First is launching the browser.
Launch browser.
Then navigate to the URL.
Navigate to gets URL.
Then closing the browser window. Then closing all browsers.
All browser windows. Suppose if you work with multiple browser windows. Next.
Then the other actions is moving forward, moving backwards.
Navigate from one URL to another. First one
to another.
Next, navigate back, navigate forward. Next.
Front, yes. Then other one is refresh.
Minimize the browser window.
Minimize the browser window, maximize the browser window, full screen of the browser window, and good. Then refresh.
Yeah. Next, testing point of view, verification point of view, capture browser URL. Next,
yeah, window, the
capture
handler,
window
the
handle in order to handler. Work with multiple browser windows. Okay, next, page. Limited operations on page, limited actions. Page. Get page title. Sometimes for verifications, we use this one. Get page title. Next, it is a rare use. Get page source. Next, get page URL. Page URL, browser current URL, same. Next, Srilalita. Operations or actions on edit box. See, actions on edit box. What are the actions? What is the primary action on edit box? Primary action. Still not responding.
Enter text.
Enter a value. It is primary action on edit box.
See, okay, sir.
Enter a value. Enter a value. This is primary. Next, observe test automation point of view. Some verifications. Suppose GCRIT. Observe Baba Wale. Here username 8 box is there. Username 8 box is there. Okay. Suppose in my page, as per developer's info, 3 edit boxes. Username, password, next, login type. Login type is drop down. Username, password. For example, another edit box is there. That XYZ edit box. Here XYZ edit box is not showing. For that we need to conduct status of XYZ edit box. See, check existing status. Existing status of edit box. Observe Baba Wale, username edit box is there. What is the existing status of username? True. It will return boolean. True or false? Existing status of username. True. Suppose existing status of XYZ 8 box. False. Existing status of password 8 box. True. Existing status. Next. Check enabled status. Enabled, ready to conduct operation on that element. Readiness of the element to conduct actions. Status. Check the elements enabled status. Sri Lalita. Username. What is the enabled status of username? See, in general English we use yes or no. In testing we use true or false, logical values, boolean values. What is the enabled status of username?
False, sir. No.
False. Enabled status is false.
Yes, sir.
No. Observe. If you want to enter something, you can enter na. It is ready for conducting operation na.
Okay, sir.
See, enabled status of this 8 box is true. Sometimes you can find some 8 box are there, but in disabled state. That time you can't enter any value. That is disabled. Disabled means false. Enabled status true means enabled. Status false means disabled. Observe Shivaji, okay. What is the enabled status of login button?
Sir, it's true.
Just a minute. Facebook. Now observe. Click. Now observe. What is the enabled status of the share button?
False.
See, if you click this one, nothing happens. False. Suppose you enter something ABCD. Now what is the status?
True.
This time true. It is enabled. That is the status. Next, secondary operations. Clear. Clear value. Suppose while navigating your application, if you have a value already there in your edit box, suppose you are navigating through this application, some value is already there in username. I want to clear this value. Selenium will clear. Secondary operations, sometimes it is required, but primary operation or primary action on edit box is enter a value. Next, get or return. It is also secondary operation. Get or return the value. Get or return the value, Sri Lalita. Suppose in our eight box some value is there. I want to capture that value. I want to capture that value for verification point. You can capture that value using Selenium. You can store that value into variable. Then you can use it. That is capturing value. See, in manual, in real life, we copy this one. Okay. Capture the value, etc. We covered maximum. Any other actions on eight box? Shivangi, any other actions?
Sir, I guess we have covered the maximum.
We covered maximum. See, first one is primary. Baba Wale, you come. Powerful object or powerful element in web applications. Powerful element. Link. Actions on link. Before going to discuss actions on link, see, if you familiar with actions on web elements properly, then it is easy to automate using Selenium. In Selenium, we have several Selenium WebDriver commands. You can use those commands for conducting actions on elements. If it is manual testing, manually we conduct. If it is automated testing, using test tool commands or methods. If it is UFT supports test methods. Selenium supports commands. Using Selenium WebDriver commands, we can conduct actions. First of all, you need to know the actions. Before going to discuss this one, actions on elements. Types of links, Baba Wale. Types of links. See, first one, as per user interface design. Text links. Functionality almost all same. Text links. Next, image links. Functionality common. What is functionality? Redirecting from one location to another. Observe, Baba Wale. Suppose Google homepage, here Gmail link is there, right side top. What type of link? As per user design, user interface design, it is text link or image link? Baba Wale not responding. Sri Lalita.
That is text link first.
Text link. Click this one. It is redirecting to another location. Okay. Next, suppose seleniumhq.org. Here observe. Selenium IDE image is there now. Selenium IDE image. Center of this page. Click this one. Redirecting to another location. What is this one? What is this element?
Image link.
See, this is as per UI design. Next, types of links. Types of link. As per functionality. core functionality is same. Core functionality is redirecting, but some variations are there. Observe. Not variations, location difference. Same. Technical term, inbound link. Inbound link. Inbound link. What is the functionality of this one? Redirects to another location. Another location. Or another location in the same page, in the same page, or another page in the same application, same application. These are inbound links, redirects to same application. Next, outbound. Outbound links. Redirects to other another application. Redirects to another application. Observe Baba Wale. Suppose Wikipedia Selenium page. Selenium software. Here Selenium grid link is there. Selenium grid. Click this Selenium grid link. What happened? Redirecting to another location, but same page. Observe the page. Same page, na? Same page. Observe Sri Lalita. Selenium web driver.
No, it's not her.
Put mute. Observe.
Yes, sir.
Click history. History available in the same page. Click this Selenium web driver available in the same page. Means this link is redirecting to another location in the same page. Same page. For example, here written in Java. Click this Java. Click this Java. Redirecting to another page. Another page. But in the same application. What is the application? Wikipedia.org. Same application. Suppose click this create account link, redirecting to another page, but same application. Just a minute. Here website seleniumhq.org is there. Click this link. It is redirecting
to another
application. This is another application. This is
Sir, that Selenium page. Sir, is this a control? No, sir. The Selenium HQ home page.
Selenium HQ. Just a minute.
Sir, this project downloads documentation support. Sir, is this a one frame and divided into multiple tabs?
No, it is not. It is single frame only. Actually, it is not frame. It is not. Who is asking?
Shivangi, sir.
Shivangi, it is not a frame. Observe here. Inspect console. here it is not showing any other HTML document na. Only top window. Yes. Only top window. The top window HTML document is selenium.selenium.hq.org. Here,
yes,
it is tab only. It is not a frame or under any frame. Under top window. Top window means main page only. For example, observe. Suppose Java doc. It has three sections, three frames. Inspect console. Here observe. Top window is there. Top window is there. Next class frame. Class frame also having one HTML document. Next package list frame also having one HTML document. Next package frame, third frame also having one HTML document. Okay.
Okay, sir, got it.
Multiple HTML documents. Outbound links. Some other flavors also there. Sri Lalita, other flavors, for example, broken link. Broken link. What is this broken link, Anuradha? What is this broken link? Baba Wale, broken link.
It's for blank page or page content removed.
See, URL is there, no data. I think removed. Okay. Broken link. Page with no data. Earlier it might be there. Broken link. Deleted content. Next, email link. Observe Sri Lata, you can find some links in web pages. If you click that link, it will redirect to go to email. It will redirect to email window na. To address, from address, you can send emails, email links, etc. Now observe Shivangi, we covered maximum or any other type of links?
No sir, we covered maximum.
Okay, cool. Next, continue Anuradha. What is the primary action on link element? Primary action on link element.
Redirecting.
Click. Redirecting click. Is internal functionality.
Okay.
Redirecting is find the difference between these two. See,
okay.
Click is action. Click is action.
Action.
We call that action is click. Click is action. This is action. This is action. Next, you are telling na redirecting. Redirecting is internal functionality.
Yes.
Internal.
It is like action to be performed on that action what you're doing.
Internal functionality. Just a minute. Element link. Next, element button. Element button. Here also external action is click na. Click.
Yes, sir.
What is internal functionality for buttons? Internal functionality for buttons, Baba Wale. Link redirects. Link redirects.
Redirects.
Button submits. Suppose one form is there. If you, after entering the form, you click sign in or some button name, okay, it will submit the form. Login, submission, submits. Any problem? Suppose radio button. Radio button, actually external action, we click that one, or you can say select that one. What is internal? Selects na. Next, checkbox. We click that one. Observe Shivangi, we click that one. Next, internal.
So this is also select.
Here, check. Uncheck also. If already checked, uncheck. Checks, unchecks. Okay. Observe. Link is there. Click this one. Redirecting. Our action is click only. Next, GCRIT. Enter username. Next, enter password. Next, click login button. It submits. If the details are correct, then it will provide next page. Otherwise, it will show error message. This is button. Next, observe. Here, radio buttons are there. Male, female. Click. Male button selected. Next, here, newsletter checkbox is there. Click, checked. Again click, unchecked. Suppose again click on this mail radio button. No. If you select another radio button from the same radio group, it will be unchecked automatically. Okay. Okay, na Baba Wale? Now come to this one, main one. Actions. Click. Click. I'm writing external actions. Continue. Anuradha. Here also you can use verification methods. Check existence of link. Check. See, in manual testing also we check for existence of link. Suppose as per developer's info in Gmail homepage, Gmail link, images link, and YouTube links are available. Example, as per developer's info, if you go for that YouTube link, that is not visible, not exists. So existence of YouTube link on Google homepage is false. Gmail link true. Okay. Check enabled status. Enabled status. Next, if required, it is optional. Return link name, etc. Next, fourth one, fifth one, image. Image actions, actions on image, image button, image link. See, first general image. What are the important actions on general image? For example, this Google, it is general image. See, check existence of image. No need to checking enabled status by default false only, disabled. If required, return image name. Next, B, image button as like push button. Here also external action is click. Means submits. Next, verification actions, checks enabled status. Next, check enabled status secondary. First, existence. If it exists, then we can check enabled status. Suppose if not exists, then no meaning of enabled status. Enabled status. Return. Button name. Etc. I will show that element. Next, image link. See, as like text link. See, user friendliness point of view, developers create image link. Click. Check existence of image link. Next, existence of check enabled status of image link. Enabled status of image link. Next, return link name, etc. Observe Sri Lata. See. this Google general image static. Next, Selenium HQ. Observe right side top. Yes, see, Selenium image is there. Click this one. Nothing. It is general image. General image. If it is image link, it will show hand icon. It is general image. Show static. This Selenium IDE. Static. Show this Selenium IDE. It is image link. Image link. Observe this hand icon. Can you view my mouse pointer hand icon?
Yes, sir.
Next, first one, Selenium WebDriver is also link. Click this Selenium IDE, redirecting to another page or another location. Next, suppose Mercury Tours, sample application for EFT testing, EFT sample application. Observe here username 8 box, password 8 box, sign in. Sign in is, see, functionality wise, it is button. It is button. Put mute, Srilita. Your system also making noise. Okay. Functionality wise, it is button. Click this one. It submits. Suppose without entering any data, if you click, it won't submit. See, again, it is asking. Submit. The submit is image button. The sign in is image button. Inspect this one. Observe Shivangi. The sign in is image button. Observe name login. What is the type of that element?
Image.
Image. That is image button. Functionality as like push button. Next, Baba Wale, sixth one. Actions. Actions on checkbox. Actions on checkbox, Baba Wale. What is the primary action on checkbox? Anuradha, primary action on checkbox?
Select and unselect.
Okay. External action is click. We apply click only. This is external. Next, internal. Selects an option. Selects checkbox. Here, not an option. It is only option. Selects checkbox. Once again, if you click that one, unselect. Or you can say, check or uncheck. Checks or unchecks. Okay, na? This is primary. Next, verification operations. Check existence status. Next, check enabled status. For checkboxes, one more status. Check or verify. Or you can write like this. Verify existence status, enabled status. Next, selected status. etc. Observe Shivangi, suppose GCRIT. Oh. Online catalog. The newsletter checkbox is there. Existence, true. Enabled status, true. It is ready for conducting operation on it. Next, selected status. Selected status, Shivangi. Selected status, false. Next, this time selected true. Status is true.
True.
Good. This is about selected status. Next, actions on button, push button. Actions on button. Button means push button. See, external action is click. Click means submits. Submits. Next, existence. Verify existence. Next, verify button existence. Button existence. Next, verify button enabled status. Enabled, true means enabled. Enabled, false means disabled. Return button name. Return button name. Next, actions. Actions on radio button. Radio button. Here also external action. Click. Click. Internal selects. Selects. No unselect option for radio button, Shivangi. If it is a checkbox, you can unselect. Next, verify. Radio button existence. Radio button existence. Next, verify radio button enabled status. Next, verify radio button selected status, etc. Shivangi, actions on drop down box. Actions on drop down box. Drop down. What is the primary action?
Select an item, sir.
Good. Select an item. It is primary action. Next, here also existence status. Verify drop down box existence status. Existence. Next, verify. Enabled status. Put mute. Why your mics are voice devices are providing more noise? Okay. Next, enabled status. Okay. Next, optional return items count. Return items count, etc. Anuradha. Actions on list box. List box, drop down box, related elements. Here also select existence returns item count, all are common. What is the difference? Select one or more items.
Yes, multiple items.
Multiple items. One or more. Multiple items. Multiple items, not mandatory. Okay, one or more items. List box. Okay. Next, actions on combo box. Combo box. Combo box also as like drop down box. What is the difference? See, combo box means drop down box plus edit box. See, suppose if one drop down box is there, in the drop down box 10 items are there. You can select any one of those items, any one of those available items. Suppose one city drop down is there, in the drop down some cities names available, but not my city name is not available in that drop down. That time you can't select your city. If it is combo box, some cities information available, your city is not available, that time you can enter your city in combo box. Getting?
Yes, sir.
Here also, same like drop down, difference is on select an item, next enter new item if required. Enter new item. Next, operations on web table or actions on web table, or you can say HTML table. Just a minute. see HTML examples. Observe, this is HTML table. Static. First, check or verify existence of web table. Next, no meaning of enabled status, by default disabled. Next, if you want return a cell value, return a cell value. Next, return rows count. See, in practical chapters I will show. Return columns count. Etc. Now you come, Shivangi, important one. Frames. Actions on frames are here. Action is not correct term. Handling frames. Frames in a web page. Handling frames is a web page. Action is not correct term. What is frame? Frame means a section of a web page. See, just a minute. Frame means section. Just a minute. Why it is showing like this? Just a minute. Anuradha, can you hear me? Hello. Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir. We are able to hear you.
Some network problem from my side only. Continue. Frame means section of web page. A section of a web page. And frames contain elements. Next, if it is manual testing, we can directly operate elements in any frame. See, if it is otherwise, you can say like this. In manual testing, we can operate elements in any frame directly. Next, in automated testing using Selenium, we can't handle elements directly. First, we need to switch from top window to a particular frame and operate elements. Okay, now these three points, Shivangi, these three points.
Sir.
Observe. Suppose page with frames, selenium.hq.org download tab, Java doc. Suppose if it is manual testing, launch this page. I want to click in the second link of third frame. You can click. Suppose I want to operate first link in first frame, you can operate. Suppose I want to operate some actions link in second frame, you can operate directly. But in automated testing, not like that. You need to switch from top window to particular window, then you can operate. How? I will show an example. Observe. Example, my manual operation. See, in a web page, total in a web page. Otherwise, total three frames in a web page. Total three frames in a web page. Next, steps, general steps. First step, launch web page. Web page with multiple frames. Launch this one. Next, operate or handle an element in third frame. Just a minute. Operate an element in third frame. Next, operate an element in first frame. Next, operate or handle. Second frame. Observe Anuradha, total how many steps? Shivangi, how many steps?
Four steps.
See, in manual testing, also same. Same. Launch web page, same steps in manual testing. That is general. Same steps. Suppose automated testing using Selenium. First step, same. Second step, switch. How to switch, that we will discuss in practical chapters. Switch from top window. Whenever we launch web page, our focus on top window only. Top window to third frame. Next, operate an element in the third frame. Next, we can't switch from one frame to another directly via top window only. See, switch from third frame to top window. This is called back to default. Next, observe. Switch from top window single board. Window is single board. Switch from top window to first frame. Operate an element in the first frame. Next, Now we are in second frame now. Just a minute. Switch to third one. Switch to default. Second frame to top window. Next switch from top window to. Oh, we are in first frame. First frame to top window. Next top window to second frame. Operate an element in second frame. Observe Shivangi. This is the process of automated testing. There are how many steps? 9 steps na?
9. Yes, sir.
If it is manual testing, only 4 steps. See? Like this, we have to handle frames in web pages. Frames in web pages. Next. This is about web elements and the actions on web elements. See, mouse over, that is one arrangement. Inline elements, date picker, all are arrangements. Next one, general topic. General topic, you have to involve Anuradha. General topic. You know now, web application testing. Just a minute. Web application testing. See, first web application, we are going to conduct web application testing using Selenium. Web application can be done in 2 ways. What are the two ways?
Manual testing and automated testing.
2 ways. One is traditional manual testing. Second one is automated testing using any test tool, not only Selenium. Automated testing. Manual testing, automated testing. This is ways of web application testing. Next, types of testing can be performed on web applications. Test types can be conducted on web applications, Anuradha. Our tool is functional test tool. See, one is functional testing. This functional testing can be done in 2 ways, manual, automated. This is one.
Automation.
Next, performance testing.
Yes.
Performance testing. Okay. Other people may conduct or you may involve if you have performance test knowledge. But here, manual testing is impractical, isn't it?
Yes.
Automated testing only possible. Okay. Next, any other test types can be applied on web applications, Sri Lalita? Security testing is there. Somewhere it is part of functional testing. Some independent concept also. The web application security is more important. Next, usability, look and feel. Usability testing. See, for this usability testing, Shivangi, manual testing only possible. Automated testing is impractical. Getting?
Yes.
Why? Tools can't judge look and feel aspects. Only human user can judge look and feel aspects. Next, performance testing. Manual testing is impractical. automated testing only possible. Why? We can't organize thousands of machines, thousands of test engineers, and we can't apply thousands of users concurrent load. That is impractical. Automated testing only possible. Suppose if it is usability testing, for usability testing, automated testing is impractical, manual testing only possible. Other, suppose compatibility testing, browser compatibility, database compatibility, say front end compatibility, different sub flavors are there, subsets are there, compatibility. Compatibility testing. See, database testing is part of functional testing, also part of performance testing. Okay. Anything other? It is also independent concept. Database testing. Any other, Anuradha?
I don't think any other
reliability
coming to mind. Reliability.
Reliability testing. It is also non-functional test type. Next, web application availability. Availability testing. Simple one. Availability testing. Etc. Next, last topic for the day, important one. Observe Sri Lalita. Common functionalities, generic functionalities in web applications, web software applications. Here, observe Anuradha, web application. In one classification, web application two types. One is computer web application. Computer web application. Another one, nowadays trending one, Baba Wale, trending one, computer software. Another one,
mobile.
Good. Mobile software, mobile web application, mobile web application. What is the difference between suppose one application is there, Anuradha, for that we have computer version as well as mobile version also. What is the relation between these two, computer web application and mobile web application? What is the relation? Are they different or related?
Or related, sir.
Related.
Almost related.
Almost related. Yeah. Good. Almost related. And one most more thing, related. Most of the time, mobile web applications are clones. Mobile application is clone of
web application.
Computer web application. Computer web application. Mobile software is clone of computer software. First priority, computer software. Okay. Next, common functionalities in web applications. Tell me any common functionalities. Identify. See, functionalities may vary from one project to another. Common functionalities. Suppose.
Like the login.
Web forms. Web form submission. Isn't it? The submission may be login or something. Web form submission. Next. Login. login. Before this one, elements availability, checking the all required elements availability in web pages, elements availability in web pages. Next, web form submission. Observe form submission. Just a minute. If it is registration form or inquiry form, submission. Here field level validations as well as form level validations. Field level validation means, suppose one field is their phone number object. That phone number object is accepting valid inputs or not, and preventing invalid inputs or not. That is field level validation. Form level validation means, after entering all mandatory fields, whether the form is submitting or not, that is form level validation. Just a minute. Okay, that is slow. I will see tomorrow that one. I will explain. Web forms here, registration. Registration forms, inquiry forms. Registration forms, inquiry forms, etc. Next, login. Next, any other common? Baba Wale, any other? Some web applications may have payment process now. Hello, Sridhartha, can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Payment, any financial transactions.
Any financial transaction, payment process. If it is banking application or e-commerce application, payment process. Next, any other?
So, capture.
Captcha means verification code. Captcha verification. It checks whether the user is manual user or not. Captcha verification. Any other payment process? See, all these are user side, user interface. Next, when it comes to admin interface, first one, create, edit, and maintain master data, server side testing. Observe this point, Anuradha. Create, edit, maintain master data. Master data means required data for running the application. Suppose you open icicibank.com, that is user interface. From that you can get types of loans available in the bank, term deposits, types of accounts, savings, current account, etc. From where you get that information? Suppose from observe, if you deploy software application first time, no data, bank admin enters that data in admin interface, that can be reflected in user interface. Getting this point?
Yes, sir. That master is the initial
master initial. Data that is called master data, required data for running the application. Suppose if you launch icicbank.com, in user interface you can get branch locators, ATM locators, etc. info. How can you get that information? That admin user enters the data in admin interface as master data. Suppose we have 500 branches in India, in Hyderabad 10 branches, Delhi 20 branches, Mumbai 30 branches. That admin user enters the data. Suppose after 3 months we are opening new branch, that information will be added in admin interface as master data. Suppose we are removing some branches, admin user removes that data. Suppose we have four types of banking loans: housing loan, vehicle loan, educational loan, some personal loan, etc. Next month onwards we are introducing new loan, agriculture loan, gold loan, etc. That admin user enters that data in admin interface. End users can access that data for their transactions. Getting this point? Any problem, Baba Wale? Raise query?
No queries, sir. Yes, sir, we are getting the point, sir.
Reports. Any other in user, say admin interface. What is the purpose of admin interface? What is the functionality of admin interface?
To handle the master data, to create, maintain, and
create and maintain master data. Maintain master data. For example, if it is a healthcare application, hospital management system. See, end user means that hospital operator can enter the data. Suppose if it is lab module, tests, x-ray, blood test, etc. How can they get that information, basic information? From admin interface, admin user enters the data. X-ray 100 rupees, blood test 50 rupees. Like here end user can enter the name of the patient, x-ray, blood test, etc. Then they can generate the bill. Okay, suppose next month onwards our hospital is hiking charges, x-ray instead of 100, 150 rupees. Admin user modifies the master data in admin interface, that can be reflected in user interface. Okay, otherwise you can say master data are maintenance of the application. Application maintenance. Next, what is the purpose of user interface? What is the purpose of user interface? Conducting specified business operations. Conducting specified business operations. Suppose if it is banking application, online banking application, admin side, enter branches, ATMs, types of loans, types of term deposits, types of interest, interest rates, interest rates, types of accounts, etc. Next, user side, customer account holder login, balance inquiry, balance amount transfer, amount transfer, bill payments, etc. Business operations. Any other? Shivangi, in web applications, any other?
Not recalling, sir.
Okay. One small theoretical assignment. By this weekend, you complete this one, Anuradha. Identify the common functionalities. Some yes, other sir. Functionalities also there in web applications. So if you identify, yes, then you can easily cope up with any new project. Okay. Now I am going to close Okay, welcome. Now I am going to close the session. Any queries regarding this today's session? Web elements and actions on web elements. Sri Lalita.
No questions, sir.
Welcome. You fulfill that requirement. Shivangi. Okay.
No queries, sir. Fine for the day.
Okay, welcome. Baba Wale.
I am good. Thank you very much.
Welcome. Anuradha.
No, very soon.
Okay, welcome. Okay, we'll meet tomorrow, same time. Thank you.